Imagine an AI that can reason like a human, solving puzzles it's never seen before. It sounds like science fiction, but MIT's latest research might have just made it a reality. Their method, test time training, could be a game changer for artificial intelligence. And stay till the end to discover how these breakthroughs might redefine intelligence, both human and artificial. And what if I told you OpenAI's O1 model might be another piece of this puzzle? Could this be the breakthrough that brings us to AGI? Let's dive in. And here's a twist. The connection between MIT's research and OpenAI's latest advancements could hold the key to unlocking intelligence beyond human capabilities. Picture it unlocking secrets hidden in patterns and codes faster than you or I ever could. This is the AI future we're exploring today. Before we dive in, I want you to know that this video is designed to make even the most technical concepts easy to understand. By the end of this video, you'll have a clear understanding of this groundbreaking research and why it matters. And here's a question for you to think about as we go along. Do you believe AGI, artificial general intelligence, is achievable in our lifetime? Stay with me because what you'll discover today might completely change the way you think about AI's future and humanity's. AI is great at tasks it's trained on, like recognizing faces or translating languages, but when faced with something completely new, it often struggles. This is what scientists call out-of-distribution problems. Think of it like a student who memorizes answers for a test but can't apply that knowledge to real-world problems. It's like cramming answers for a test without truly understanding the subject. That's where the ARC benchmark comes in. It's like an IQ test for AI filled with visual puzzles that require reasoning, not memorization. Most AI models fail miserably on these tasks, but MIT's team has developed a method called test time training that changes everything. Imagine what could happen if AI overcame these limitations. It could reshape entire industries, from medicine to engineering. And here's why this matters to you. As AI starts reasoning like humans, it doesn't just impact tech, it affects jobs, creativity, and even our understanding of intelligence itself. Let me ask you this. What if you could learn new skills in real time? Imagine taking a math test and learning calculus on the fly just by looking at the question. That's basically what MIT's test time training is doing for AI. Cool, right? Think of it as learning on the go, just like figuring out a new recipe while cooking. Here's how it works. The AI starts with some basic knowledge, like how we might know simple arithmetic, but as it faces a new problem, it teaches itself, adapting in real time. This isn't magic, it's just a clever way to make AI smarter during the task itself. How amazing would it be if humans could do the same thing? Think about the possibilities: an AI doctor diagnosing diseases it's never encountered, or an AI architect designing structures beyond human imagination. Or what about self-driving cars learning to navigate unknown terrains on the spot, or robots instantly adapting to factory malfunctions? Now let's talk about the ARC benchmark, which stands for Abstraction and Reasoning Corpus. It's a set of visual puzzles where the goal is to identify the underlying rule and apply it to new examples. For instance, you might see a grid where shapes and colors follow a specific pattern, and you need to predict the missing pieces. You might think visual puzzles and abstract reasoning are topics reserved for AI experts. But trust me, once you see how ARC works, you'll understand why it's such a powerful test for intelligence and why this research is so exciting. Here's something fun. I'll flash an example of an ARC puzzle later. Think you can solve it faster than an AI? And here's the kicker. This isn't just about puzzles. ARC is a window into whether AI can truly think beyond pre-programmed tasks. The results were stunning. MIT's approach achieved a 61.9% accuracy on ARC, matching the average human score and setting a new state-of-the-art for neural models. Even more impressively, this method outperformed many symbolic reasoning systems, proving that neural networks can handle abstract reasoning without relying on predefined rules. This means AI isn't just following instructions, it's adapting and learning dynamically, much like humans do. This breakthrough suggests that AI can solve complex problems by allocating computational resources during the task itself, like a human reasoning through a difficult problem. And here's the exciting part. This breakthrough could lead to AI solving problems we haven't even thought of yet. Now let's take a moment to talk about OpenAI and their O1 model, which has been creating quite a buzz. Some claim that the O1 model is a stepping stone to AGI, and this connects directly to the kind of reasoning breakthroughs discussed in the MIT paper. The O1 model is designed to enhance reasoning capabilities during inference, much like the test time training approach from MIT. In both cases, the focus is on equipping AI to handle novel out-of-distribution tasks. OpenAI's O1 model has shown remarkable results, performing on par with PhD students in certain fields like physics and biology. But does this mean we've reached AGI? It's like watching puzzle pieces falling into place. But is the big picture of AGI still incomplete? Could OpenAI's O1 model be hiding the first spark of AGI's reasoning ability? Some researchers believe the signs are already there. If we combine the insights from the MIT paper with OpenAI's advancements, we can see a roadmap forming. Test time training might make future models more adaptable and efficient. OpenAI's focus on reasoning and scaling computation could unlock new levels of creativity and problem-solving. Imagine this kind of reasoning powering everything from space exploration to personalized education. The possibilities are endless. While reasoning is a critical piece of the puzzle, it's far from the only requirement for achieving AGI. To create an AI that truly mimics human intelligence, we need to address several other challenges, both technological and logistical. First, let's talk about learning and memory. Just like humans build knowledge over a lifetime, AGI must continuously learn and retain information, applying it across different tasks. This requires not just advanced algorithms but also vast and efficient data storage systems capable of preserving and retrieving information instantly. Then there's generalization. AGI must go beyond solving specific problems. It needs to adapt to completely new challenges without retraining. For instance, if it learns to drive a car in one country, it should also navigate roads in another with entirely different traffic systems. Achieving this level of adaptability demands innovation in model architecture and training strategies. But even if we perfect the algorithms, we can't ignore the resources required to power AGI. Let's start with the hardware, GPUs and TPUs. Training and running AGI models need an immense amount of computational power. The latest large-scale AI systems already require thousands of GPUs operating in parallel, consuming significant amounts of electricity. Speaking of electricity, this is a major hurdle. Energy consumption for training large models is astronomical. For example, training a single state-of-the-art AI model can emit as much carbon dioxide as 5 cars do in their entire lifetimes. To scale AGI, we'll need breakthroughs in energy-efficient computing or widespread adoption of renewable energy sources. Then there's the cost. Developing AGI is incredibly expensive. Training a sophisticated model like OpenAI's GPT-4 is estimated to cost tens of millions of dollars. Scaling this to AGI-level capabilities could push costs into the billions, requiring unprecedented investments from governments, corporations, and possibly even global collaborations. Another key aspect is data. AGI will need access to a diverse and comprehensive data set to understand the world. However, gathering and processing this data raises concerns about privacy, security, and ethical use. Who decides what data an AGI learns from? And how do we ensure this data doesn't introduce biases or inaccuracies? And finally, there's the question of infrastructure. Hosting AGI won't just require advanced data centers, it will need globally distributed systems to ensure real-time performance. Imagine an AGI that's assisting with disaster relief. It would need immediate access to resources, accurate local data, and rapid computational feedback, all coordinated seamlessly. In summary, while test time training and reasoning are monumental steps forward, they represent just one facet of the larger AGI challenge. To truly achieve AGI, we must address these resource constraints, innovate in hardware and energy efficiency, secure massive funding, and solve ethical dilemmas along the way. Building AGI is not just a technological endeavor, it's a global effort that touches every aspect of science, infrastructure, and society. So there you have it, a once technical paper broken down into clear and relatable ideas. If you've made it this far, you're now ahead of most people in understanding how AI is evolving, and why the journey to AGI is so fascinating. And here's my challenge to you, what do you think? Are we standing on the edge of a revolution, or is AGI still a distant dream? Share your thoughts below. And if you enjoyed this breakdown, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. The future of AI is unfolding faster than ever, and together we can explore it.